There are two ways of making a CNC program: by manual programming and CAD/CAM. For manual programming, you need to have the coordinates for each point. Then, using the right G codes, you need to connect the points. In CAD/CAM, you need to make a CAD profile or CAD model. For making the program, you need to use the CAM capabilities of the software. A programmer role is to select the tool, cutting parameters and strategies. The rest of the job is done by CAM software. The time taken for making a program for 2D profiles will not differ much in both these methods. A CAM software is having advantage over manual method for making program for a 3D profile. Any point which you define using two dimension is called 2D, and which is defined by three dimensions is called 3D. This sketch, what you are seeing, we'll try to make a program in two different methods. One is manual programming and the other by using a CAD/CAM software. Zero is indicated here. So this is your X0, Y0, and this is your X-axis and this is your Y-axis, and all other required parameters are given. Now, for this point, start point of this angle is known. End point in x-axis it is known, y-axis it is not indicated, but there is an angle. So using angle, either you can calculate the y-point and make a program, or directly you can use an angle command. Similarly, for radius, either you can calculate the start and end point of the radius values, or you can use automatic radius command using the intersection point. Let's see how we can make a manual program for this profile. As we already discussed, the zero is defined here and it is shown in the sketch. So this is X0, Y0. This is X plus, this is Y plus. Now, we can start the machining from this point, middle of this line. So this is 100, so we'll start at X50, and this is 100 mm, so we can start at Y120, that is considering the safe position of the cutter. So here you can see the program is begun with G0, G54, G64. G54 is work coordinate system, G64 is continuous mode, tool command, tool change, spindle RPM, clockwise rotation, G90, absolute, X50, Y120, Z50, then Z5, G01, Z-5, F1000. So we are going to cut at a depth of 5 mm. MSG command will display profile on the screen when it is run. Then with G41, the tool is positioned to Y100. So this is 100. So here the tool is positioned. How it is G41? Now we are going to cut from here to here. So when you look at the direction of cut, so the tool has to be to the left of the profile. So G41, tool at left. This is X100. Now this point x is 150, but y is not defined, not shown, whereas we have an angle defined. So using angle command, we can directly program this point. So the program line would be ang equals minus 45. So how it is minus 45? If you look at the clock, different needle positions. So the 3 o'clock position is considered as 0, 12 o'clock 90, 9 o'clock 180, 270, 6 o'clock. So this is how the angles are defined. So this comes in between 0 and 270. That means this is 315, or the other way, minus 45. So we program it as ang equal minus 45 and x 150. X is known. Y, the controller will automatically calculate. Then y0, the intersection point, and the automatic insertion of radius R&D equals 10. And x100, so again, x100 is not shown here. How we can calculate? This is 100, this is 50, so the balance is 50. So here is a right angle triangle with 45 degree. So you know that when it is 45 degree, this side and this side will be equal. So now we know that this is 50, so this is also 50. Here is another 50, 50 plus 50, 100. So this point is calculated as 100. So x100, then again angle. So you know that this is 9 o'clock position, 180 degree, minus 45, so 135 degree. Ang equals 135, y 50. So automatically the controller will calculate the position, and then automatic insertion of radius R&D equals 10. Then x0, again automatic insertion R&D equals 10, y100, R&D equals 20, x50, g0, g40, y120. Again, after cancelling the radius compensation value, the tool is lifted to y120. That's all. That's how we can make the manual program for this. And then it is just lifting and the programming command. Now let us see the simulation for this. Cycle start, tool change, initial position of tool at save position, second position of Z, and position at Z minus 5. So here you can see the command which is running, G01 Z minus 5 F1000. So it is position there, and G41 Y100. Now here you can see the profile is being displayed because MSG command is asking for profile. So whatever is written in double quotes is being displayed here. Now the next command is x100, so tool has moved already. Then next is angle equal minus 45, x150, moved already. Next command is y0, R&D equals 10. So R&D equal 10 is automatically creating that round. Then x100, then next command is angle equal 135, y50, R&D equal 10. instead of y50 we can also give x50, because in the drawing x50 was given. So either x or y, any one variable we can define. Using angle, the other coordinate will be calculated by the controller. Then automatic insertion of radius is there, then x0 and radius. So here you can see the radius is 10 and your tool is also 20 dia. That means the radius for the cutter itself is 10, so here there is no movement automatically created by the tool. There is no further movement required. Now this one, next command is y100, R&D equals 20. Yes. Next is x50. And then cancellation of radius compensation G40, and then Y safe position Y120, and then lifting in Z. So we'll again see this toolpath in 3D view. That's it. There are two methods for making program in a CAM software. One, for 2D profiles we can use simple sketch, and for complicated profiles you need to make a 3D model and use it. So now we are making a sketch. Dimensions are defined. Can see various dimensions marked. Zero is defined. All the dimensions, linear as well as angular, are defined. And radiuses are inserted. So whatever is the radius, that value is given. In this case 10 mm 10 mm 10 mm 20 mm. So you can see how quickly a sketch is created. Now the sketch is defined for making a CAM program. Plane is defined, which Z value the program has to start. A tool is selected, dia 10 mm in mill. Then the strategies are defined. Toolpath we can see. Now we'll do the post processing. So we need to define the machine for which we need to create the toolpath, NC output. We'll see another example of making CAM program using a 3D model. So whatever sketch we have used in the last example, the same thing, by using a single simple extrusion command, it will become 3D model like this. Now the selection of the plane, tool, and then the strategies are defined in CAM software for making a program. Can see the toolpath is ready now. You can play the toolpath. Can see the tool is moving. And we can select the same thing to make a post-processed output. Post-processor is also a small program which convert the toolpath into an NC output file. Now your program is ready.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have liked it, press like. Subscribe the channel for more such videos. Click the bell icon for getting notified on new videos. I will come with more videos like this. Bye for now.